Good morning viewers, welcome to the digital class. In the previous session, we worked with the reading text, The Storied House. We know that Bayaji, who rendered 35 years of service in the Bombay dockyard, returned to his home village after his retirement. He had a long-lasting wish of building a storied house. He earned 2,500 rupees and he wanted to use the money to build a storied house for his large family. He reached his village very happily and suddenly he came across one village head, Bhujba Patil, who really troubled him with a few questions and who looked him down. But Bayaji answered him very humbly. And out of the conversation, Bhujba Patil came to know that Bayaji was planning to build a storied house for his family. Bayaji reached his house and all his family members greeted him warmly. And everyone was very happy. And they had a big celebration there. Of course, Bayaji did not bring anything for anyone in particular, and he announced that he decided to build a storied house for the family because they were living in a small house which was not at all sufficient for all the members of the family. And all the family members were very, very happy. Soon, the news reached another village head, Kondiba Patil. On hearing the news about Bayaji's new house, Kondiba Patil was very, very angry. He came to Bayaji and threatened him. And Bayaji was quite innocent. He did not know what mistake he did. He did not do any mistake. Because there was only one storied house in the village which was owned by Kondiba Patil. And Kondiba would not tolerate another storied house. And Kondiba told Bayaji not to build a storied house. If he really insisted on building a house, he could build a normal house, but not a storied house. And he even threatened Bayaji that Bayaji should leave the village if he built a storied house. And Bayaji was totally helpless. His long-lasting desire of building a storied house could not be materialized anymore. However, he made up his mind and decided to build a concealed storied house, which would look like a normal house from outside. Very shortly, the house was ready and Bayaji was very busy with performing the housewarming ceremony. All relatives came there. They were very happy. They had a singing program and famous singers were invited and everyone was busy the whole night. Suddenly, the pandal caught fire from all directions. And the newly built house turned into ashes in no time. And Bayaji's heart broke. He started crying, "My house, my house." And he rushed into the house and he was seriously injured. And Bayaji lost his life. It was a very tragic situation. Everyone came there to celebrate the housewarming ceremony. But they had to witness the death of the owner of the house. The next day, an inquiry was called by the village heads and it was concluded that the accident broke out due to a petromax flare-up. Bayaji's sons did not lose their heart. They determined to fulfill the last wish of their father and they decided to build a real storied house. Dear children, this is the gist of the reading text, The Storied House. In today's session, we are going to work with the discourse news report. The objectives of today's session are, the children will be able to get the gist of the text, The Storied House. They attempt the discourse construction news report, and they identify the process of writing the news report, and they take up discourse construction, and edit the product collaboratively and compare their product with that of the teacher. What is a news report? A news report is an academic piece of writing about facts. There is no scope for imagination. It's about a particular event or an incident. Normally, it is presented in the third person point of view. Here is the layout of the news report. The headline, the introduction, the body of the news report, and conclusion. Have a glance at the headline. The headline presents the gist of the news. It provides essential information about the particular event, and it can be associated with a picture related to the event. And the introduction contains lead paragraph. The lead paragraph provides essential information. It works with 4 W's: who, what, when, where. I mean to say, who have been involved, what has happened, when has the event happened, and where has the event happened. And the body of the report presents the detailed information about facts and supporting details. How has the event happened? Why has the event happened? It contains quotes of the witnesses of the persons or relevant people. It provides the gist of the event. It may have comment on the event, and generally conclusion tells us about the future, what is expected to happen next. Let's watch the video.
Dear children, in today's class we are going to work with news report. So, what is a news report? A news report is an academic piece of writing that gives the details of a particular event or incident. And in this class we are going to work with the outline of the news report. So, a news report contains a headline and lead paragraph. Body of the report. And finally, conclusion. We all know that the headline gives the details of the news report in a nutshell. Usually, a headline is nothing but a very short sentence in which the focus is on the information. And lead paragraph or introduction gives the basic information, and precisely it answers 4 important questions: who, what, when, and where. I mean to say, who are the persons involved, and what exactly happened, and when did it happen, and where did it happen. So, generally, lead paragraph is a very short one that gives us the basic information. And if you come to the body of the report, in which we try to answer 2 important questions: how and why. So, it gives us the detailed information of the incident, how the incident happened, and why it happened. Okay, and conclusion, which gives the summary of the news report, and it may contain comments. Comments made by the witnesses or comments made by the persons who are involved or who are related to the event, and what next.
Features of the news report. A news report focuses on one event. It tells us about facts and supporting details, logical organization of ideas, and most important information should be presented first. And usually we'll find short paragraphs in the news report. They should be clear and easy to read. And we need to use formal language in the news report. Moreover, proper layout and indenting. These are very important for a news report. Apart from that, there are some more features of the news report. Chronological ordering of the ideas, well-formedness, spelling, capitalization, and punctuation. While working with the process of writing the news report, here are a few points. The headline and the picture or photo associated with the event, organizing the ideas, writing the draft, editing, and reformulating. Now it's the time for us to take up the analysis of the news report. Here is a news item. Have a glance at it. Please see the headline, lead paragraph, body of the report, and conclusion. So see the headline. Generally, the headline is very short and it gives us the essential information of the news report. An introduction answers the four questions: who, what, where, and when. And the body of the report presents details of the news. It may have quotes relevant. And the conclusion gives the gist of the news and what is going to happen next. Dear children, take your textbook and go to page 163. You will find two versions of the news report. Read the given news report and try to analyze it. So see the headline and introduction. The headline is very simple and very short, and introduction answers the four questions. And we have seen that the paragraphs used in news report are short and clear. And see the body of the news report. It gives all the details of the news. And see the body of the news report. It gives all the details of the event. And the conclusion answers the question, what is going to happen in the future? Dear children, let's have a task. Write a newspaper report on Bayaji's death. Before taking up the task, here are a few points. So we are going to write a news report about Bayaji's death. So please make a plan. What will be the headline? What will be the introduction, and what will be the body of the news report, and what will be the conclusion? So when we are working with the news report, the headline should focus on one event. So we may get the information, Bayaji's death and cause of his death. And in the lead paragraph, who Bayaji, what happened? Fire accident that has caused Bayaji's death. Where has the event happened? Bayaji's house in a village in Maharashtra. When has the event happened? During the housewarming ceremony. Or while working with the news report, we may use a particular date. Preferably in the news report, we have to use the latest date. So in the body of the report, we may give the information related to the event and how the incident happened. It's a Petromax flare-up And we may use quotes of the eyewitnesses or family members of Bhaiyaji. And in the conclusion, we may make use of relevant comments and what is expected to happen next. So, we know that Bhaiyaji's sons have decided to fulfill their father's last wish, and they have decided to build a true visible storied house. Let's take up the task. Work individually and write the news report on Bhaiyaji's death. I hope you have done your individual news report writing. Now work in groups, share your ideas with the members of the group and come out with one group product. Let's watch the video. I hope you are ready with your group products. Now it's the time for the presentations.
I am Raghavendra, 10th English medium, JPHS Manikonda. This is our group work. Petromax flare up in kills man, Manikonda, November 1. A retired person was killed in fire accident took place in Manikonda, Telangana last night. Bhaiyaji, a retired person was killed in fire accident that occurred at last night. People was busy in arrangements home warming ceremony. When the fire broke out, it spread quickly and left the house in ashes. Bhaiyaji was seriously injured by fire accident. Totally burned the Bhaiyaji body. An inquiry was performed the Petromax flare-up. It is a not fire accident, it is the murder. Tell by the Raghavendra, Bhaiyaji relation. The two villages rascals are due by this plan. Tell by Jayakrishna Bhaiyaji neighborhood. Bhaiyaji wishes to build the real story house. This is the wishes of the Bhaiyaji. The Bhaiyaji eldest son Pandal said, I will build real story house start next day. Sorts the Hindu Navamata.
My name is
Dhirika,
10th class English medium. This is our group work. Retired person killed in fire accident. Manikonda, November 1. A retired person was killed in a fire accident took place in Manikonda, Telangana last night. Bhaiyaji, a retired person was killed in the fire accident occurred that last night. People were busy with arguing. Bhaiyaji, a retired person, was killed in the fire accidents occurred that last night. People were busy with arrangements for housewarming ceremony. When the fire broke out, it spread quickly and left the houses ash. Bhaiyaji was seriously injured. His body was dumped, total burnt. and inquiry was performed and conclude that the fire accident was caused by a Petromax flare up. It is not an accident. It is a murder.
Now it is the time for editing the news report. While editing the news report, here are a few points. We have to see the layout of the news report and relevant information presented in the headline. And we have to see whether the lead paragraph answers the four questions: what, who, where, and when. So when we take up editing, we have to select one group product for editing. So while editing, we have to see whether the ideas are properly organized, and most important information should be presented first, and indenting of the paragraphs. And precisely, the paragraphs must be clear and short. And we have to see the well-formedness of the sentences. I mean to say, word order in the sentences and the person, number and gender features and agreement, particularly subject-verb agreement. And when we work with well-formedness, we have to see whether or not any excess words or missing words, or whether proper word forms are used. I mean to say, prefixes, suffixes and derivatives. And we'll have to see the tense and spelling. And punctuation in the news report, particularly capitalization, the use of capital letters, stops and commas, and quotation marks if we take quotations of the witnesses or persons relevant. And when we work with thematic editing, we have to check the discourse specific features. Here the layout, paragraphing, outline. In the layout, we have to see the headline, introduction, body of the report, and conclusion. And paragraphs must be short and clear and indenting. And the conclusion should give us the gist of the news report, and it may tell us about the future.
The process of editing. See the headline: retired person killed in fire accident. Is it okay?
Okay.
Good. Manikonda, November 1st. A retired person was killed in a fire accident. Took place in Manikonda, Telangana last night. Here it must be M. Bayaji. A retired person was killed in the fire accident. Occurred that last night?
Last night.
Okay, and here what should be?
Yeah.
P should be captured. People were busy with arrangements for housewarming ceremony when the fire broke out. Okay, it spread quickly and left the house into ashes. Bayaji was seriously injured again. So I must be a small one. His body was totally burnt. An inquiry. It is a problem. An inquiry was performed and concluded that the fire accident was caused by a Petromax flare up. It is not an accident, it is a murder, said Radhika. So, by his daughter. The village rascals planned this. However, by his sons decided to fulfill their father's last wish. We'll build a real storied house and show our strength, said Pawan, Bayaji's eldest son. Okay? So, we have come across errors related to punctuation and grammaticality. And see the layout. Is it okay? Right. And see the information given in the first paragraph or lead paragraph, and description and conclusion. And you can see in the first paragraph, We got the important information of the news report, and here we have the details and the conclusion, the future plans. So what is going to happen in the future is also explained. Okay? Now, have a look at the teacher's version.
And finally, we'll have to make a comparison of our product with that of the teacher's work. Dear children, so far we have worked with the news report and we have attempted editing the news report. Now it is a time for us to talk about the distribution of marks for news report in our examination. Here is the distribution of marks for news report in our examination. Use of appropriate headline and lead paragraph carries 2 marks. Body of the report carries 2 marks. Use of appropriate language. Particularly in news report, we have to use formal language. It carries 2 marks. And organizing the information carries 1 mark. Well-formedness carries 1 mark. And the cohesion, use of linkers carries 1 mark. And conventions of writing carries 1 mark. Dear children, in this session we have worked with the discourse news report. We attempted writing the news report. And we have worked with the news report individually and collaboratively. And we have taken up the process of editing the news report. And we have made a comparison of our product with that of the teacher. I hope you have enjoyed today's digital class. That's all for us today. Have a nice day.